Hello guys and welcome back to our channel. Today we're gonna talk about, is it possible to increase your total lung capacity or not? And if you don't know what is a total lung capacity, this is what I was explaining on my last video, check it out. In short, it is the maximum amount of air which you can have in your lungs after you finish your inhale. So when you inhale, and after you finish your inhale, this is your total lung capacity. So the question is it possible to increase it or not? Before we continue, my name is Sergey. I'm a freediving instructor trainer, and on this channel, I'm sharing everything with you, what I know about freediving. Okay, the question is it possible to increase your TLC or not? And some people thinking, yes, it's possible. Some people thinking, no, it's completely impossible. And the funny part that these both people are right. The difference is what they mean while they are talking about this topic. And today we're gonna try to understand both of this party, and then you can decide is it possible or not. First of all, let's start with the theories that no, it's impossible to increase your total lung capacity. So people who usually stating this, they mean that it is impossible to increase your theoretical volume of your lungs. So your lungs have a certain structure, it starts from your trachea and it ended up with your alveolus. So this structure could not be changed. Doesn't matter if you're doing stretching, doesn't matter if you're doing some kind of special breathing, this structure wouldn't change. This is a fact. Okay, so this is why when people saying that it's impossible to increase your lung structure, then they are correct. Your lung structure would not be changed. We're not talking about young competitive swimmers, because yes, when you're young, most likely when you're practicing swimming on a serious base, then this is gonna affect your total lung capacity. It's gonna be increased. But since you're already not a child, swimming could not increase it any further. Okay, so the first answer, no, it's impossible, because this structure is already, this is already what you have. And so guys, when you hear that someone is saying that it's possible to increase your total lung capacity, what do such person means? So there are three factors which limited the amount of air which you can inhale. Factor number one is the elastic recoil of your lungs. I'm not going to go into details what it is. You can Google it, you can find it in Wikipedia, but basically it is the ability of your lungs to contract after inhale. So this is why when you finish your inhale and your muscles relax, your lungs is decreasing in size. One of the reason is the elastic recoil of your lungs. So this factor is probably could not be changed. So let's forget about this factor. Factor number two is muscle force. It is how much muscle force is going to be applied to expand your chest. Because remember, your lungs always following your chest. If you're increasing your chest volume, then your lungs is going to increasing as well. So how you can work on the ability to apply more muscle force? There's a many exercise, and on this channel I already share a few of them. So for example, 3-section breathing. When you train separately how use your diaphragm to increase your chest volume, how to use your chest muscles, intercostal muscles, and how to use your top muscles. So when you're practicing such exercises or some different exercises, you create awareness how to use different muscles. So, and then, yes, it's possible that experienced freediver can apply more force compared to untrained person to expand his or her chest, and this is going to help to inhale more air, again, compared to untrained individual. And the last factor is thoracic elasticity. So guys, remember, normally our lungs is pretty elastic. However, we have a rigid case around, and this is our rib cage, right? So our rib cage is pretty stiff, because normally no one likes stretching actually this zone. We do stretching for our legs, for our hamstrings, for our neck, for our shoulders. But if you are not free diver, then more likely you're not doing specific stretching for your thoracic cavity. right? And again, on this channel, I already did a few videos how you can stretch your thoracic muscles, how you can stretch your intercostal muscles, both using only your body weight and also like special equipment, kind of special equipment, let's say a fitness ball, or for example special wooden props. If you don't know about such exercise, check them out. I'm gonna put the links to these videos in the description. Super useful exercise. Okay guys, let's come back to these three limited factors. As you can see, factor 2 and factor 3, which are limiting our ability to inhale as much as possible, actually can be trained. Actually, this limitation can be shifted a little bit. So this is why if you're practicing special breathing exercises, you're more likely gonna be able to inhale more. And also, if you're practicing special stretching exercises, it's also gonna help you to inhale deeper compared to what you was able before. So guys, now let's make a summary. Your theoretical volume, which is predicted on the, like, you can say amount of your lung tissues, this is would not be changed regardless what kind of exercise you do. However, on practice, you can inhale more air with certain freediving exercises. Let's say you're not increasing your total lung capacity. I think it's gonna be a little bit more accurate if you're gonna say that you're actually coming close to your potential. So you have a theoretical potential, your lungs have a theoretical potential to accommodate like this amount of air. However, without proper training, you're probably far away from your potential. And if you do certain training, then you're gonna come closer and closer to your lungs' theoretical potential to accommodate as much air as possible. Okay guys, hopefully this video was useful. As I said, if you're looking for these exercises for both your exercises for your muscles and exercises for like special stretching, then check it out in the description. I'm gonna put all the links there. So hopefully this is gonna be helpful as well. So once again, thank you for watching this video. I hope this video was helpful. If you like it, don't forget to click the like button, and I will see you next time.